are ill. Listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy, it's hard cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they in for a worse fate. One day when the boss get hungry,
yes, you go beyond the pay.
But go under the sea. Under the sea, nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We what the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we after hook up. We got no troubles, life is the bubbles. Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, dig in the earth and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The newt play the flute, the cop play the hop, the place play the bass and the sound, the chop, the bass play the brass, the chub play the tub. The flute is the duke of soul. The way he can play the names on the strings, the chub rocking on the blackfish. He sings his felt and his front, they know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to Sri KDU's Lower Primary Concert. Please enjoy our production of The Little Mermaid.
Thank you. great, the salty sea air, the wind blew in your face, a perfect day to be at the sea.
Oh yes.
A fine strong wind and a falling sea. King Triton must be in a friendly type mood.
King Triton? Why, rule of the mer people that thought every good sailor knew about him.
Mer people, Eric, pay no attention to this nautical nonsense.
But it's not nonsense, it's the truth. I'm telling you, down in the depths of the ocean they live.
Royal Highness, King Triton! And presenting the distinguished court composer, Horatio Thelonious Ignatius Crustaceous Sebastian! Your daughters, they will be spectacular!
Yes, and especially my little Ariel.
Yes, yes, she has the most beautiful voice. If only she turns up for practices once in a while.
Uh-huh, let me see.
Ah, this is special. This is very, very unusual.
What is it?
It's a dingo hopper. He was using his little babies to straighten their hair out. See?
A dingo hopper. What about that one?
Ah, this I haven't seen in years. This is wonderful. A banded bulbous snarf bat. Now, the snarf bat dates back to prehistorical times when humans just stare at each other all day. Got very boring, so they invented the snarf bat to make very fine music. Allow me.
Music? Oh, the concert! Oh my gosh, my father's going to kill me!
The concert was today!
Yeah, maybe you could still make a little buzzer to read or something?
I'm sorry, I've got to go. Thank you, Scano.
Anytime, sweetie, anytime.
Yes, hurry home, princess. We wouldn't want to miss old daddy Sarmish now, would we? Ha! Sarmish indeed! Bah! In my day, we had fantastic feasts when I lived in the palace. Now look at me, wasted away to practice nothing. Banished in exile to practice starving. While he and his flimsy fish folk celebrate. Well, I'll give him something to have this room now. Flotsam, jetsam! I want to keep an extra close watch on that pretty little dad of his. She may be the key to Triton's undoing.
I just don't know what we're gonna do, you young lady.
Daddy, I'm sorry.
As a result of your careless behavior.
Careless and reckless behavior.
The entire celebration was...
Well, it was ruined. That's all. Completely destroyed. This concert was to be the pinnacle of my distinguished career. Now, thanks to you, I'm the laughing stock of the entire kingdom.
But it wasn't our fault. Well, first the shark kissed us. Yeah. So we tried to, but we couldn't.
And we, whoa! How was that? We were safe.
But then the seagull came, and then it was yeah.
A seagull? What? Oh, you went up to the surface again, didn't you?
Nothing happened.
Oh, Ariel, how many times must we go through this? You could have been seen by one of those barbarians. By one of those humans.
Daddy, you're not barbarians.
You're dangerous. Do you think I want to see my youngest daughter snared by some fish eater's hook?
I'm 16 years old. I'm not a child anymore.
Don't you take that tone of wash with me, young lady. As long as you live under my ocean, you'll obey my rules.
But if you would just listen.
Not another word. And I am never, never to hear of you going up to the surface again. Is that clear?
Teenagers. They think they know everything. You give them an inch, they'll shit all over you.
Do you think I was too hard on her?
Definitely not. Why, if Ariel was my daughter, I'd show her who was boss. None of this flitting to the surface and other such nonsense. No, sir. I keep her under tight control.
You're absolutely right, Sebastian.
Of course.
Ariel needs constant supervision.
Constant.
Someone to watch over, to keep her out of trouble.
All the time.
And you are just the crap to do it.
How do I get myself into these situations? I should be writing symphonies, not tagging along after some headstrong teenagers. What is that girl up to?
Okay.
If only I could make him understand. I just don't see things the way he does. I don't see how a world that makes such wonderful things could be bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look around, here they show. She's got everything.
I'm